Well, good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here from theuptrend.com with today's look at the Canadian stock market. In the pre-market this morning, U.S. stock index futures are above fair value, so we are looking for a higher open in the U.S. on Tuesday morning. Of course, a close on Tuesday below 2276.12 would give us a new daily sell signal for the S&P 500 cash index. Looking at the VIX, VIX on a sell signal right now, an inside day. A lot of inside days yesterday, so fairly quiet trading. We're seeing money go back into the bond market, the XBB back on a buy signal, so some money is trying to hide at the moment. Looking at the world of currencies, the US dollar index is still on a sell signal. That is a mirror of the euro, which is still on a buy signal. With the US dollar index on a sell signal, you would expect most other currencies to be on a buy signal. And there's the Canadian dollar. Recently made a higher high. We had a pullback yesterday. On Tuesday, we're looking for a close below 76.10 to give us a new sell signal there. We are currently overbought. We're at the top of the flypaper channel, and this is the time and place where we'd expect a pullback. Whether that pullback makes lower lows or not is yet to be discovered. We'll just know that over time, but right now it is looking fairly bullish where we have been making higher lows and higher highs over the past month. Looking at Bay Street itself, the TSX is on a sell signal inside day yesterday. We need a close above 15,517 to give us a buy signal on Tuesday. The pros and the public are currently intertwined. We are stuck in the middle of the trading range. You can see that at 15,312.50 up to 15,625, that's the range we've been in, and we're right in the middle of that range right now. Pros and the public intertwined. They don't know which way we're going next, and a breakout or a breakdown of the recent trading range would certainly be a clue, and there's our next targets to the upside and to the downside. Now, we are oversold right now, but not extremely oversold. This is the percentage of stocks on the TSX 60 currently trading above their 10-day moving average. And you can see over to the left that we have been more oversold in the past than we are currently. Now, what's working, of course, so we've been watching gold and silver stocks for some time. Nice move up yesterday. We're currently overbought. This is not the best time and place to get into this sector. A lot of the gains have already been made. We did break out above resistance at 218.75 yesterday, and so 234.38 is our next target to the upside, and then 250. Now, we are overbought at the moment, but not extremely overbought. Looking back, you can see that we have moved all the way up to the 100% level, 100% of the stocks in this sector trading above their 10-day moving average, and so we still have some room to go on the upside. Now, Barrick is still leading this sector higher. It broke out above resistance of our mathematical resistance is $25, and we closed above that yesterday. Notice we closed above this high back here, so that is a good sign. Look, two lines up, 28.13. That could be our next playing field to the upside if we can break away from the $25 level. 24.85 was the low yesterday, so we're still stuck to the $25 level, but certainly optimistic that we closed above the most recent high. Now, looking at the flypaper channel, you can see that now that we're starting to take out the high here, that the next major highs are back from last summer. And this is where everything started to fall apart. We made a significant high, and then we made a lower high, and that was certainly a tell for a lot of people. And then a month later, we broke down through the flypaper channel. So here we are starting to break away from the flypaper channel and up at the $30 level. That target certainly is coming into focus for a lot of traders. No guarantee, of course, that we get there, but it is certainly something that people are starting to focus on. Looking at financial services, they've been treading water up here for some time now, up at the top of the trading range. Nothing going on at the moment. What is interesting, of course, is the fact that we're running out of momentum here. You can see back in early December, we had almost 100% of the stocks in the financial services index trading above their 10-day moving average, and that has started to dissipate. And so as we're still sitting up at these levels, fewer and fewer stocks are participating. So certainly the big banks are participating, and there's CIBC. When you see a chart like this where there's, we're basically trading sideways, It's often best to move back and give the stock a little more breathing room, and we can do that with our midterm chart. And you can see that a close just above the 110 level there would give us a sell signal on Tuesday. Now, what's not working? Well, one of the banks that's not working is a Canadian Western Bank is on a sell signal right now. Home Capital, CI Financial, Sun Life, they're all on sell signals at the moment. Now, one of the Canadian financial services stocks that I follow very closely is the TSX. I'm currently short this stock. It generated a buy signal as of Monday's close, and so I'm now going to have to cover my short position and go long on Monday. We are looking for a close above 70.12. We closed at 70.20, and so that's a buy signal. On Friday, we got an early warning signal, fall through to the upside on Monday. If you're going to take this trade, of course, as with every trade, you must be willing to sell it on the first close below the lower channel line, and on Tuesday that is 68.98. Now notice the lower channel line is flat at the moment, and so if this trade does start to find upward momentum, it's going to take a few days for that lower channel line to start to curl up. Now I'm not buying it because the pros are taking control. It looks like they're coming back to take control, but they're certainly not doing that on Tuesday morning. What's interesting about this trade is that traders have been willing to buy the dips off the flypaper channel. We came down, we found support at the flypaper channel. We were extremely oversold, which is unusual for this stock, but there we were down at the bottom of the screen. You can see how oversold we were. You can see that this stock can remain overbought for long periods of time. And so just be aware of that, that the balance of power is certainly with the professionals. It is a stock in a bull market and is continuing in a bull market, even though it had a pullback to the flypaper channel. Now, of course, any trade has risk. A low-risk trade is never a no-risk trade. And even if you filter out the high-risk trades from the low-risk trades and take only low-risk trades, they all have risk. And so, of course, you must be willing to sell this stock, as with any other stock, on the first close below the lower channel line. Now, what's not working on the TSX? Energy stocks made a new low yesterday. Panic selling. We saw some panic selling yesterday as we punched through the bottom of the panic zones. Things were working well for this sector. We were making higher highs and higher lows, and that stopped recently. And now we're starting to make lower highs and, as we saw yesterday, lower lows. And so there's the TSX Energy Index. If you look off to the left-hand corner, bottom left-hand corner of the screen, we have the potential of finding support down here. We are oversold at the moment, but not extremely oversold. If you look to the left, you can see that back in September and October, we were more oversold than we are now. And so there is still room to move further to the downside. Crude oil is not the problem at the moment, still on a buy signal here. What seems to be the problem is natural gas, and natural gas is still on a sell signal, made a new low on Monday. Some examples in this sector, and most of the stocks look pretty similar: Suncor, Canadian Natural, Crescent Point, Crew, Cenovus. They all look pretty similar. They're all heading in the same direction, and I would certainly be interested in buying any of these if they were to turn around and start to give us buy signals. Now, just a couple of the most actively traded stocks. B2 Gold was the most actively traded stock yesterday, and the second most actively traded stock was Ithaca Energy, which had a huge pop yesterday. So a couple of the volume leaders making higher highs on Monday. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. I'll be back on Wednesday morning to look at the U.S. market. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again soon.